Will the sins of the forgiven saints be reviewed? Now, this is a question that has probably troubled a lot of people. You know, I for one, don't want my sins reviewed. When I go to heaven, you know, I've got some past that I don't want to even think about. And I don't want anyone else to see my past record. Yeah, there are some things that are dark, and I don't want them brought up again. So the question is, will those sins of us forgiven saints be reviewed also? Are they going to be in the books? Well, this is one of my favorite scriptures in all the Bible. Isaiah 44, verse 22. I have blotted... Oh, say it again. I have blotted... Oh, that sounds good. Let's say that again. All four of those words. I have blotted out. Thank you. That sounds so good. I have blotted out as a thick cloud your transgressions, and as a cloud your sins. Return unto me, for I have redeemed thee. Isn't that beautiful? Right from Isaiah's pen. Blotted out. Now, these are our sins in the books of record. Blotted out with the blood of Jesus. Blotted out. You know, I've heard that God never forgives sin. Are you aware of that? He doesn't forgive sin. I'll let that sink in a little bit. He only forgives the sinner. Are you realizing? He separates the sin. He dies for the sin, doesn't he? The sin. If the sin could be forgiven, he wouldn't have had to die. It's the sinner that he forgives. He separates you from your sins, and he takes the sin on himself and dies the death that you deserve. And then the sin that you deserve is blotted out. Your book will have nothing there. You'll look for all those sins. You'll be like, where are they? You know, my book could be a huge volume. You know, I can just imagine. Before I was a Christian, the angels were busy with me. But how do we get these sins blotted out? 1 John 1:9. You may know that. I don't know if this is in your lesson, but 1 John 1:9. I think this is the simplest way to explain it. The Bible says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us, not the sins, he forgives us of those sins, and then he cleanses us from all unrighteousness. Very important. It starts with confession. We haven't touched a lot on this deep aspect of the gospel, but confession, this road to glory starts with confession. I remember working in the hospital one time. I was in physical therapy department, but I was doing wound care. That's all I did for 2 years, probably, maybe three, wound care in a hospital. I had this cart, and I'd go up and down there and treat patients and see the most glorious things you've ever seen. I remember this one patient was ready for discharge. His name was Mr. Campbell, and the doctor said he could go, but they were a little concerned about this wound that he had. He had a bandage on his leg, and he wouldn't let any of the nurses see it. No one can look at this. He said, oh, it's fine. I'll just take care of this. He would wrap it in like the toilet paper or some gauze that he would find and just kind of tape it up there. And no nurses could look at it. And it was time for him to go. He really wanted to get out of that hospital. But the doctor says, now he can go, but you really got to have the PT department go look at that wound and let me know it's okay before we can discharge him. And he was very reluctant with this. So they came down to me and says, okay, could you go look at this guy's wound? And if it's okay, let us know and we'll discharge him. So I went down there, and I remember taking the bandage off his leg. I think it was right around here, right around this area of his leg. I undid the bandage, and oh, the odor. I saw the most gruesome wound on his leg. He had been hiding this thing for weeks, and it was getting really bad. He had, it was gangrenous. It was already getting gangrene in it, and necrotic tissue everywhere, and it was pretty hopeless. He had gangrene already, and I had to tell the hospital, the doctor, that we can't let this guy go. I mean, he's gonna lose his leg, and which he did. He lost his leg. They had to amputate his leg, and he was right back in the hospital, and then we did wound care on a stump then after that for a while. But all because he wouldn't confess this. He was hiding this. Confession is liberating, and it can save you. But if you hide these sins, there's no way God can blot them out. You have to confess them. And then, of course, the next step in this process is repentance, right? You've heard confess and then repent. That's why the Bible says that he is faithful to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He doesn't leave you just in the confession. He wants to cleanse you and make you ready to be citizens in this heaven, and he's going to take us.